एक कुंडली 100 समाधान, देश की हर ज्योतिषीय पद्धति के समावेश के साथ संपूर्ण आकर्षक और सबसे सटीक एस्ट्रोसेज बृहत कुंडली। आज अभी लें, क्योंकि भविष्य में ही छिपे हैं जीवन के संकेत।
हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ एस्ट्रोसेज, द वर्ल्ड्स नंबर वन एस्ट्रोलॉजी पोर्टल। माय नेम इज शाश्वती एंड आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू अनदर स्पेशल वीडियो ऑफ एस्ट्रोसेज। As we have promised that you will not miss out on any of the updates taking place in the world of astrology, so I'm here today to talk about the transit of Sun, which is taking place on the 14th of May. Now, all of us are hoping that the lockdown comes to an end, hopefully on the 17th of May, but we are not quite sure of that, are we? Well, lockdown or no lockdown, you can now easily know which changes are yet to take place in your life, in the upcoming days of the life, in the upcoming days of your life because of this transit, as I will be giving away the transit predictions for all the 12 zodiac signs in this video specifically. So get ready to know about your health, your finances, your love life, your marital life, and many other aspects of your life in the aftermath of this transit. First of all, let me talk about the timings of the Sun transit, which is actually taking place in Taurus. So the Sun transit in Taurus will take place on Thursday evening, which is the 14th of May at 5:05 p.m. This is when the luminary planets leaves its exalted sign Aries to enter the second sign of the zodiac circle, which is Taurus. This event is also known as Vrishabh Sankranti in Hindi. The luminary planet will continue to remain in this position until the 15th of June. So now let me tell you why this transit will be extremely crucial for your life. So the Sun or Surya and its transit is considered an essential phenomenon in the realm of Vedic astrology because the planet is said to be the ruler of the Navgrahas or the nine planets. It is also the deity, the ruling lord of health, which provides energy to the entire world. It stays in a zodiac sign for almost 1 month before moving on, and this event is named as Sankranti. Jyotish Shastras or the textbooks of astrology state that the Sun is the soul of the world. It is the lord of the zodiac sign Leo, and its favorable position in one's kundli brings all kinds of efforts, all kinds of comforts in one's life. The Sun also bestows fame, name, respect and honor on each individual. So now let us finally move on to the transit predictions. I will begin with Aries, the first sign to be registered under the zodiac circle. So the Sun is a very dear friend of your zodiac lord, which is Mars, as well as the Shubh Karak planet for you by being the lord of your fifth house. The Sun transit in Taurus will take place through the second house of Aries natives. Such placement of the luminary planet will bring you magnificence. However, there are possibilities of some challenges in your family life. You would want to follow the rules rather than being practical right now, which will create problems for the other members of your household. Moreover, if they say something that upsets you, then you will say this too to their faces. This in turn can offend them, and there are possibilities of your relationship deteriorating. Some changes in your health are indicated during this transit, and you may have to face problems like fever, cold, and cough. This is an extremely crucial time as we are amidst the outbreak of a pandemic, so get yourself properly checked in this duration. However, this will be a favorable duration in terms of education, as student natives will acquire excellent results in their studies. Coming to the Aries natives who are in love, then success in your romantic affairs is indicated. You can introduce your beloved to your family members virtually right now, which will create an understanding between them, which means that your partner and your parents. As for the married natives of this sign, this duration is most favorable for your children as they will continue on the path of progress. The Sun transit will also ensure that they will keep moving forward in life. As a remedy, you should fill a copper vessel with water at night and keep it at your bedside. Drink this water when you wake up in the morning. Next, we will move on to Taurus, where this transit is actually taking place. So the Sun transit in Taurus will cause the planet to get positioned in your ascendant sign. The luminary planet is the lord of your fourth house. As a result, its placement in your first house will bring mixed results for you. Your thinking ability will strengthen further, and you will be able to solve even the hardest of problems very quickly. However, as you add each win to your tally, ego can arise within you, which will ruin your relations with various members of your family. The Sun transit will not be favorable for your marital life, as disputes between you and your spouse can increase. There are also possibilities of ego clashes amongst you. On the whole, there will be a lack of happiness in your relationship. Despite that, the rosy flush of life on your face will be more this week. Moreover, if required, you can also make some hard decisions right now, which others may not like in the beginning. Predictions also indicate that you can acquire wealth at this period of time, and there are also strong yogas of you obtaining some immovable property and gaining access to it. At this time, your mother can present you with a gift or estate. Simultaneously, you too will do something to acquire a mode of increasing your name, fame, and respect in the society. As a remedy, Taurus natives should recite the Aditya Hriday Stotra regularly. Next in line is Gemini, the third sign to be registered under the zodiac circle. So the Sun is the lord of the third house of Gemini natives, and during this transit, it will enter their 12th house. As a result of the Sun transit in Taurus, Gemini natives can witness an increase in their expenses. However, these expenditures will not be haphazard, but be there for a very particular reason. This duration will also make you more inclined towards spirituality, and you will be seen moving on that path. Geminis are social butterflies inherently, and the constant lockdown is making you restless. As a result, you will find yourself missing your friends, your family members who are currently very far away from you right now. The placement of the Sun in your 12th house can cause a decline in your health. The longing for get-togethers and your ki and keen can add to this. You can also suffer from pain in the eyes, insomnia, fever, headache, and body pain. Moreover, some of your opponents can also become stronger at this time and may trouble you. The placement of the planets indicate that some of you can partake in a task which is considered out of the lines of decorum. This can end up besmirching your image. Therefore, you need to pay attention to the same and avoid doing anything which can lead to such a disrespectful situation. Working professionals need to remain very careful of their colleagues at this period of time, as they can be scheming things against you. You will feel mentally weak right now, which can cause a delay in even your most accomplished tasks. As a remedy, you are advised to worship Lord Vishnu with utmost devotion every single day. Next, we'll be talking about the zodiac sign Cancer. So the luminary planet is the lord of the second house of Cancer natives, and during the Sun transit in Taurus, it will get posited in the 11th house of Prophets. This planetary movement will be beneficial for you in almost all aspects of life, and you will progress day by day. However, due to the influence of the Sun, you can face some problems in your love life. Due to a slight contradiction in your thoughts, your relationship can even turn drab at this period of time. In such a situation, you need to take help of open and mutual conversations to save your bond. Coming to the student natives of this sign, the transit will not be much favorable for you either. Therefore, you need to focus on your studies with complete devotion and concentration, otherwise your results may not be satisfactory. Your children will have a favorable time, as all their projects will succeed. They will progress in their respective fields. This duration will also finally give wings to your ambitions, and one of your long pending desires can get fulfilled now. This will bring you immense happiness. Your health will also remain strong and remain in good spirits. And with the right investments, you can make efforts towards increasing your current income. Yogas of profits through the government sector are also forming, while working professionals will receive the support of their senior officials. This transit will also offer favorable outcomes in terms of business as well for Cancerians. As a remedy, you should chant the Bija Mantra associated with Lord Surya or Sun during this transit period. Now we'll be talking about the fifth sign to be registered under the zodiac circle, which is Leo. So the sun transit in Taurus will cause the planet to get posited in the 10th house of Leo natives. The luminary planet here attains directional strength. Therefore, this planetary movement will be favorable for the natives. The sun is the lord of your sign and 10th house is its most influential position, which is the Kendra Bhav. The sun transit will bring tremendous yogas of progress for working professionals. There are also possibilities of you getting a promotion at your workplace. Your relations with your senior officials will improve and they will help you out in everything. This duration will be specifically favorable for Leo natives employed in the government sector. Some of you can also expect some kind of honor or amenities from the government. The influence of this planetary movement will be worse on your opponents and you will witness an increase in your name, fame and honor. Peace will prevail over your domestic household now. Your status in your family and personal life will increase and you will earn respect in the society. Predictions promise a good health and your immune system will also remain strong. Most importantly, your diligence will bring you success in all of your tasks right now. As a remedy, you should tie moli or kalava, which is a holy red thread, on your hand after wrapping it 6 times around your wrist. Next in line is Virgo. So Virgo natives will host the transit of the sun through their 9th house. The luminary planet is the lord of your 12th house. Due to the influence of this transitory motion, business personals of this sign whose trade is associated with foreign countries can attain tremendous gains right now. Simultaneously, Virgo natives who are employed in MNCs can also look forward to a promotion or any other form of positive growth in their company. In addition to this, many of you will also find yourself getting inclined towards spirituality, maybe even feel a spiritual longing at this time. Predictions indicate possibilities of your father's health deteriorating right now as he may fall sick. Despite that, your name, fame and honor will grow. This is because you will be seen connecting with your old friends, making groups on social media and doing all you can to bring everyone together in these trying times. Your efforts will garner praise and everyone will be impressed with you. In addition to this, you will remain involved in charity work. However, it would be prudent if these donations remain online. Virgo natives will get the chance to work out on a vacation someplace at this time. Considering the circumstances worldwide, you can plan on going on a pilgrimage once things improve. Your work efficiency will enhance due to this transit and you will improve your circumstances by yourself. There will be an increase in your pace of efforts and you will now learn how every task is accomplished efficiently. On the other hand, your siblings may have to face some challenges at this period of time. Trips are on the cards for many, but you need to postpone them for the time being. Remain inside and safe until the situations are under control all across the globe. Some of you may also end up spending money over religious activities. However, you need to understand that you will be able to save money only if you curb your expenditures. Otherwise, you can find your income lessening slightly. Health-wise, predictions promise an improvement in you and you will be finally getting rid of all the old chronic diseases. As a remedy, you should chant the Gayatri Mantra 108 times regularly. So next we'll be talking about the zodiac sign Libra. So Sun is the lord of the 11th house of Libra natives and during their transit it will get posited in the 8th house of Libra people. As a result of this planetary movement, you can expect some health issues at this time and some of you can even fall ill. You can suddenly face some skin troubles, an increase in biliary diseases and some mild fever. Thus, take care of yourself. However, these will only happen when your kundli is undergoing the dashas of some malefic planets. Doing anything outside in the lines of decorum will be unfavorable for you, as your name can be besmirched in the society. A decline in your current income is indicated at this time, and there are also possibilities of monetary losses. Thus, you will need to work even harder to attain success, and even then, the gain will be only partial. This duration is not favorable for your father and father figures, as they may face some health-related problems or some other ups and downs in their career. Librans posted in the government sector who are facing some allegations need to remain careful, as a departmental inquiry may be seated against you now. Your societal status can fall and you may suffer a delay in the fulfillment of your ambitions. As a remedy, you should bow down towards the eastern direction every day during the sunrise, and it will prove to be quite beneficial for you, as the eastern direction is the one which is dominated or governed by the sun. Next in line is Scorpio, the eighth sign to be registered under the zodiac circle. So the seventh house of Scorpio natives will host the sun transit in Taurus. The luminary planet is the lord of your 10th house and will be posited in your house of marriage and partnerships. This placement of the ruler of the Navgrahas will bring mixed outcomes for Scorpio natives. Business personals of this sign can expect tremendous profits in their trade. Despite this, it will not be a very easy time for the enterprises. For those who own their organizations in partnership, should maintain only formal and professional relations with their partner. Taking things on a more personal level can create problems later on. Working professionals can also look forward to a promotion and an increase in their salary now. You will accomplish all of your tasks with dedication and hard work, which will improve things at your office, and you will earn name, fame and respect. Your status in the society will also be enhanced now, and you will be popular amongst the people. However, this transit is not favorable for Scorpio natives in terms of their marital life. There will be ego clashes between you and your spouse, which will lead to arguments between the two of you. Your life partner can adopt a headstrong attitude towards something, which will cause a decline in the pleasure and happiness in your marriage. Despite that, there can be a change in your behavior as well. You will try to adapt to the solutions, however. As a remedy, you should rub red sandalwood and mix it with your bathing water. Next, we'll be talking about the zodiac sign Sagittarius. So, Sun is the lord of the 9th house of fortune of Sagittarius natives, and it will be transiting through the 6th house on 14 May 2020. The placement of the luminary planet here is generally considered auspicious, as the ruler's position here protects you from your opponents. The Sun transit in Taurus will bring you success in most debates as well as legal court cases. Student natives preparing for competitive exams will be victorious in their endeavors. Although your expenses will grow, however, this will not be for an illogical reason. Instead, you will systematically spend your money at the right time in the right place. Therefore, they will not affect your financial front much. Despite that, you will need to work harder during the influence of this transit, and only after that will fate show its true colors. This planetary movement will be most beneficial for working professionals. The more you toil hard, the more profits you earn. Profits through the government or the government sector are on the cards for many. If you have some stuck funds, then they may return to you finally. Simultaneously, if you had taken a loan or debt from someone in the past, then you will successfully repay that too. However, on the flip side, some Sagittarians can end up taking another debt to repay their old one, and the rest they will use to buy some items of comfort and luxury. Apart from this, your children will also progress during this transit period. As a remedy, you are advised to chant or recite the Surya Mantra regularly. Next, we'll be talking about Capricorn natives. So the Sun transit in Taurus will take place through the 5th house of Capricorn natives. The luminary planet is the lord of your 8th house, and the 5th house signifies your mind, intellect, children and love affairs. Therefore, the presence of the Sun here will bring some physical problems for the children of Capricorn natives. Moreover, they will have to work with even more concentration in their field for proper results. As for the student natives born under this sign, predictions indicate possibilities of obstacles in your education. Also, physically you will find the heat and pith nature in your body imbalanced, which may cause a delay in your tasks. Important projects may get stuck, due to which you will need to work even more carefully. In this transit period, some of you can become fed up with your current job scenario and will think about looking for a new one. Simultaneously, this duration can also bring you sudden wealth. Yogas of financial gains through the share market, lottery, or betting are also forming. Despite that, you should consult an expert before investing anywhere, and that too only after properly pondering upon it. The desire to help others will rise within you now, and you will perform some good deeds for the same. As a remedy, you should respect your father and make it a habit to wake up early every single day. We have reached the second last sign of the zodiac circle, which is Aquarius. So Aquarians will host the Sun transit in Taurus through their fourth house. The luminary planet is the lord of your seventh house, while the fourth house is the house of your comforts and happiness. Thus, the Sun's placement here will bring an increment in your amenities, yet you will not be mentally satisfied due to some reason. You will still be on the lookout for peace. Viewing your family life, it is evident that this transit will cause unrest in the environment at home. The members of your household will continue arguing with each other unnecessarily, and there will be an evident lack of harmony. Your mother's nature can undergo some changes as she becomes slightly short-tempered. The Sun will also influence your workplace right now, due to which you will be seen making efforts towards maintaining the right balance between your personal and your professional life. On one hand, your family will demand your time, while on the other, you will also need to focus more on your official tasks too. Although business persons will enjoy good moments at this time, however, you will also need to approach an expert for advice currently. Married natives will enjoy a delightful time with their spouses, and the latter has strong chances of succeeding in their workplace as well. Some Aquarius natives can also look forward to receiving a house or a vehicle through their employer. As a remedy, you should offer arg or water to the Sun regularly. The water should be mixed with red sandalwood. Last but not the least, we'll be talking about the fate of Pisces natives during this transit of Sun. So the luminary planet is the lord of the sixth house of Pisces natives, and during the Sun transit in Taurus, it will get posited in your third house. Generally, the ruler of the Navgraha offers promising results from this position. You will get the abundant benefits through this planetary movement. The courage and might within Pisces natives will grow, and you will accomplish all of your tasks with concentration and dedication. You will feel energetic, refreshed, and ready to face all challenges bravely. Journeys are on the cards for some Pisces. However, you need to postpone them until things improve on the pandemic front. Some of you can connect with your old friends at this time, which will bring you some immense happy moments. The planetary movement will be worse for your opponents, as you do not let them get ahead of you in any situation. Each victory will fortify you and bring you mental strength. Apart from this, Pisces will reap the benefits of their past labors now. Additionally, there are strong yogas of progress in your career forming right now. Many of you can utilize this time to plan for a religious trip later on. Moreover, many of you will be able to succeed in your business ventures with the help of your friends. This duration will remain favorable for spouses as well. As a remedy, you should wake up before sunrise every day, and adhering to a daily routine in general will be beneficial for you. Ensure that you follow this regime for 21 days continuously in order to receive the blessings of the Lord Sun. So this was all you need to know about the Sun transit, which is taking place in Taurus, and how will it affect your life. So I hope that you have really liked this video. If you have liked the video, then please like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for watching it and connecting with us.